Okay, hey guys, I'm here for my first devotion. And today I just want to talk about times of transition. Right now there is a lot going on. And so I wanted to tell you a little bit about a story I heard the other day. And this guy called upon his friend and he was like, "Hey man, like I need some advice." And of course, like a friend would be willing to, but he said, regarding what you need help with, did you ever read the book that I gave you?" And he said, "Oh, the one you mean, like you gave me 3 years ago." And he was like, yeah, that's exactly what I'm talking about. And the guy goes, "No, I never got around to it." That would be me. I would never read the book. I'm not much into that. He said, "Well, call me back when you read the book." And so he's thinking, what? And right before he hung up, he said, "I already gave you what you needed for this before your time of need even came." And that really stuck out to me because I think God has already given us the handbook of life. He already gave us the Bible. He gave us everything we needed for this time of panic right now. There's a lot of hysteria going on. And so he's equipped us with everything we need to handle situations like this. And he's given us the instructions from yesterday, today, and tomorrow. And oftentimes, like there's a lot of time just to think right now, to sit and do whatever. And so what are you doing with your time? I'm speaking to myself on this as well because, I mean, my screen time's probably up double what it was before the world stopped. But what are you doing? Are you reading the Bible? Are you seeking out God and trying to get peace from Him rather than what our government is saying right now? Where are you finding your peace? Where are you seeking that out? And so I think what I'm getting at is a lot of us don't like the unknown. I like to know what's happening in my life. I like to be aware of what the next steps are. And so it'd be nice if God would give us a heads up on, you know, this circumstance is about to happen. This trial is something you're about to face. But that's not what happens because we don't get to see His plan. His plan is in the bar. It's not open for us to see. And so something that I was thinking about was, what about the disciples? When they were in the Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus went over and prayed, and He had already told them exactly what was going to happen in the upcoming days, but they never truly listened. And that's what happens with us a lot of times, is we never truly listen to what God's trying to say. And we know what happens. Peter denies Jesus 3 times. He gets taken to the cross, and we can finish that story. We already know what happens. But that was a time of transition. They had to get used to seeing Jesus in the form of man to now having Him as the Holy Spirit. And so that was a big transition. And in that time, they often wondered, "God, where are you? Why are you allowing this to happen? Why me?" And I think we ask those questions a lot. And right now our world is asking, why? Why is this happening? Truth is, we don't have the answers, and we're not going to get them unless we dive into the Bible and just seek out that relationship with the Lord. And all I know is God has a purpose for everything, and our plan is not His plan, and His timing will never be our timing. I've had to learn that time and time again, especially with my struggles with battling where I'm going to go with college. And so many times God has to pry our hands off of our own lives so that He can get us out of the way and get back to what He initially planned for us. I think once we let go of all the fear, anxiety, depression, whatever it may be, once we relinquish that control, we're gonna experience true freedom. And so that's something I would encourage you all to do. And there's a quote from this book I read a little bit ago, and it's called Overcome. And if you haven't read it, I would, it's a really good one. And it said, "Maybe God isn't interested in changing the situation you're in right now. Maybe His agenda is to change you, and He's using a tough situation to do it." So my thing is, maybe Corona is the tough situation He's using for His much bigger plan. And so my one question to wrap everything up is, are you allowing your circumstances to lead you to not seek out the Lord every day? What are you doing during this time to better yourself and to grow closer to the Lord?